So welcome to the latest news. We're going to be reviewing Lewes FC Women's new season in the Women's Championship. So welcome back, Katie.
Thank you.
Rood. Welcome to latest news, Caitlin Hayes.
Yep.
And should we start with you? You're a new signing, aren't you? A centre-back, I think.
Yes, correct.
So been in the squad, what, 3 weeks?
Yeah, moved down here, spent a summer in America, and then came here ready for pre-season. Yeah, I like the area, the team.
And I know you had a good result against Ginium recently, so you played in that, didn't you? And I think you scored.
Yes. So good to get my first one.
Yeah. And so looking ahead to the championship, so how do you see that panning out that season? And where do you think you can improve on from last season?
Yeah, I think just we've seen already, or we feel it, the new players that have come in are really complementing the players that we re-signed from last season and gelling together really well. I think, we're going to take on the league. We want to get promoted at the end of the day. That's the aim, and just take
each
game as it goes.
It's a top side that gets promoted, and there are new playoffs in the Women's Championship, or is it just a top side?
I think at this stage it's just the top side.
Yeah.
I haven't heard otherwise.
So it's top spot.
Yeah.
It's top spot to get into the to the Women's Super League.
Yeah.
Okay, and then. I mean, I know that we were talking off stage about like the way that you get, you know, whether you're on a team sheet or not. And I know you've, because that's a big psychological, there's psychological aspects to where, you know, whether or not you're playing. And you've changed it for this season, haven't you?
Yeah, we had a discussion as a group, and Fran's quite open to like player input. And so we just talked about like when is the best time to find out what the team is going to be, who's in the squad.
Yeah.
So we decided just yesterday that if we get the squad list on Friday, and then players know whether they're going to be playing for the development squad or in the first team, and then hopefully by Saturday, maybe just a day before kickoff, we'll find out who the starting team is, and then we can get mentally prepared properly for the game.
And I think that's a credit to it's a compliment to the competitiveness within the team. Certainly for me in past teams, it's kind of been a given of who the starting 11 is, when the coach is going to kind of make a sub, and everybody's kind of got their feet on the firm foundations of where they stand. Whereas with this team, it's very different because nobody's safe or like secure in their position, and it goes off each practice. If somebody outworks you or outperforms you, you kind of pass your starting position.
Yeah, super healthy competition at the moment.
Yeah.
How does that work then psychologically? Because obviously you need to be a team.
Yeah.
But also, you know, you want to get in the squad, so that means that someone else is going to miss out. So I just wonder, not being a professional sportsman myself, how does that work psychologically?
I think you're just pushing each other further. If somebody's doing better than you, you know that you've got to do better than them, which means you've got to up your game. So it's constant. And you know if they're doing well, then they deserve to be playing. And the only thing you can do is hope that they do better so that you push yourself more.
Yeah. We'll leave it there for now. I know you're going to be coming on quite regularly. So, thanks for coming in.
Thanks for
Katie and Caitlin. Thanks a lot.
Thanks. Cheers, Mark.
Cheers.